स्टूडेंट्स, एसएससी हैज रिलीज इट्स ऑफिशियल कैलेंडर फॉर द जूनियर इंजीनियर पोस्ट ऑफ 2025 एंड सम इम्पोर्टेंट डेट्स ऑफ दीज नोटिफिकेशन आर दैट यू कैन अप्लाई फॉर दिस एप्लीकेशन फ्रॉम 30th of June 2025 एंड यू कैन अप्लाई फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर पोस्ट टिल 21st of July एंड दे हैव ऑल्सो मेंशनड दैट that the first phase of examination will be between 27th to 30th of October 2025. So we are well aware from when we can apply and when we are going to have this first phase of the examination. And we can clearly see that there is a limited time available for preparation of the examination. So let's talk about each and every detail that we require before preparing for this examination or attempting this examination on 27th to 30th of October this year. So number one, so first detail is that if you are from diploma or you are from BTech, in both the cases you are eligible. No experience is required for diploma, no experience is required for BTech. And this particular video is going to remain is in purely English. Okay. So next is number of vacancies. Number of vacancies is 1840 vacancies in 2018. In 2020, it were 800. In 2024, it was 1765. So you can see the number of vacancies SSC has produced per year. And based on these data, you can assume that the average number of vacancies that SSC has produced per year is approximately 1500. So based on this data, we can assume that SSC has still now not told that how many vacancies they are going to produce in 2025. But expected number of vacancies are 1500 plus. The question can be there that when we will get to know the number of vacancies in actual. So the actual number of vacancies will be written in notification, which will be given, or you can say you, it will be produced by SSC on 30th of June. So we have to wait for the official numbers till 30th of June, but we can expect more than 1500 of plus vacancies in SSC in 2025. Okay. Now we can talk about the success rate as well, because success rate is a very important parameter that we have to see. That success rate is 0.20%, 0.14%, 0.12%. If you see the number of applicants, those who are applying for this examination, the number of vacancies you are getting, and if you take these numbers and consider the number of applicants that have applied and the number of getting selected, the number of students getting selected are less than 1% every year. So this is very important to identify that if you are preparing for this examination, you need to plan your examination and you need to just go with that plan so that you can come under this very small percentage of students, those who are getting selected each year. Now, let's talk about the departments which you will see in SSC. That number one department is Central Water Commission, then CPWD, then MES, then BRO, then CWPRS, then NTRO, Naval, Farakha Barrage Project, Brahmaputra Department. These are several departments in which you can go through this particular examination. SSC has given these vacancies in 2024. The number of vacancies you are seeing department-wise in each branch is of 2024. And in 2025, we will see in this coming notification. Okay, now if you talk about the experience, BTech candidates does not require any experience in any department, but diploma candidates require 2 years of experience in three departments. First is MES, second is BRO, and third is Ministry of Defense. Only these three departments require minimum 2 years of experience from diploma holders, but in other departments as well, diploma holders also do not require any kind of experience. Okay. Now, let's talk about the exam pattern and selection process. Thus, number one is selection process. In this selection process, there is no interview, only the written examination. But this written examination consists of two phases. First is CBT1, computer-based test. And then second is CBT2. If you clear both these phases of the examination, then there will be a document verification on which you will be getting selected. So, if we talk about CBT1, in CBT1, there will be general awareness, 50 questions, reasoning, 50 questions, and from the technical part, from whichever branch you are going to apply, civil, mechanical, electrical, 100 questions from that branch. And it will consist of total 200 questions, which will be of 200 marks. The CBT1 paper will also be having negative marking, number one. Number two, calculator will not be allowed in this examination. And this examination will be of 2 hours, or you can say 120 minutes. Okay. Now, if you clear this examination, CBT 1, then you will be able to give CBT 2 examination. And in CBT 1, one thing you have to particularly look into is general awareness, which is coming of 50 marks. It consists of several subjects like history, polity, economy, geography, physics, chemistry, biology, current affairs. So it looks like it is a one subject, but it is consisting of many other subjects like from general awareness, general science, and current affairs. So particularly look into this, and I have given a general distribution of marks out of 50 of a particular subject they are asking every year. It is average number. It is not from a particular year. It is from the average numbers that they have the questions were asked in last 5 years. Okay. Now, if you clear such CBT 1 examination, then you will be able to give CBT 2 exam. So CBT 2 will be consisting of only technical part from your branch related questions, and each question will be of 3 marks. So 100 questions, each question of 3 marks, total 300 marks. Calculator will be allowed. They will only provide the calculator in the form of virtual calculator on their screen. So this paper is also of 2 hours. So you have to clear this, and after that only the one stage is left, that is document verification. Nothing else. But what one thing you have to remember is, here the selection is not only based on CBT 1 or CBT 2 marks. Here the selection is based on both the examination. CBT 1 was of 200 marks, CBT 2 was of 300 marks. So the final cutoff or the final merit on which you will be getting your department, desired department, will be based on the marks you have obtained out of 500, not out of 200 or not out of 300. It will be totally based on 500. So this you have to particularly remember when you are preparing for SSCJ. The maximum age limit is 30 years, but only one department is there, that is CPWD, in which you can go till the age of 32 years. And this age limit I have given is in case of general category student. If you are from some other category student or SC, ST, OBC or some other category student, some age relaxation is also provided by the SSC. So you can add this age relaxation and you can get the maximum age by which you can get selected in SSC JEE depending upon the category you lie in. SSC JEE is a Group B post job in which basically we calculate a salary out of total basic salary, DNS allowance, HRA they are providing you, a total salary of approximately 60 to 65,000 you will be getting. Depending, it also depends upon the place you are working or the department you are working, but the average salary you will be getting is 60,000 per month when you get selected in SSCJ, and it is a very decent and a good salary as well. So if we talk about SSCJ, when you will go for the examination, in your particular department, there are different types of questions asked. Numerical questions, some are calculator-based questions, some are not calculator-based questions, some are statement-based questions. There can be match the following type of questions, there can be concept questions, there can be assess and reason questions, there can be picture-based questions. And this particular type of questions you are seeing is, I have written here, is from CBT1. But you will see in CBT2, similar type of questions are same asked, but the percentage, or you can say the ratio of these questions in CBT1 and CBT2 can be different. So whenever you will be studying for the examination, you'll get to know. Now, the SSCJEE has many other advantages, like job security is there, good pay is there. You can, if you like to travel, then using different department you can travel across India. This is some basic things you get out of SSCJEE. And number the most important point is promotion structure. If you clear this examination, you will be able to basically start with a junior engineer post, and after 7 to 8 years of time you will be promoted to assistant engineer. From JEE to AE it takes approximately 7 to 8 years. In rarest of the rarest case, it takes 8 to 10 years. Okay, now if you talk about the cutoff, because you have to clear the examination. So CBT 1 examination, if you will be clearing and you are from civil department, so last known cutoff of 2024 was 122.92 in case of a general category student. And based on your category, you can see what was the cutoff out of 200 last time. See, if I talk about OBC, it was 116.82. Economically weaker section, it was 109.20. For SC, it was 101.85. And for ST, it was 97.83. This is for civil engineering student. And if I talk about mechanical and electrical students, then last known cutoff of 2024 was 132.06. 131, 120, 112, 101, 86, 43, 58, based on different categories. So you are able to see in which year what was the cutoff based on your category and based on your branch. So you have to focus these numbers that you should at least obtain to clear the CBT1 examination. Okay, and if I tell about SSCJ, it requires at least 6 months of time. And when I'm making this video, 6 months of time is not left. We are approximately having 5 months of time. So there may be some problems you might be facing while you are preparing for this examination. Okay, it may be regarding your classes, it may be regarding your notes, it may be regarding your test series, it may be regarding your strategy, it may be regarding your practice book. So if you're facing any problem, you can just let us know. I have attached a form below in the video. You can just fill that form. Let us know what the problem you are facing. We'll surely try that. We can solve your problem, because on test book, we provide test series, we provide classes, we provide anything required for SSCJ examination. We have produced toppers in SSCJ last year as well. The rank 1 was from test book, rank 2 was from test book, and we are eyeing this year that rank 1, 2 and 3rd should also be from test book. And we want that you can be that student. But first, you have to let me know that what kind of problem you are facing while preparing for SSCJ. So just fill the form. Let us know. We'll provide you the best solution, that whatever is required by you. Okay. So do comment and let me. Thank you.